So in the previous lecture, we were studied about the disease typhoid. Now one more disease which is called as ringworm. Remember that ringworm is a fungal infection of skin. See, in the before diseases, whatever we have studied, the causative agents were the viruses or the bacteria. Now this ringworm, it is a disease which is a fungal infection. Remember that it is caused because of fungi. Which species of fungus are responsible for causing ringworm? It is because of fungal species, it belongs to genera Trichophyton and Microsporum. Why this disease, this ringworm, it is seen on skin only? Because this fungi feed on keratin in skin, hair and nails. What is this keratin? Keratin is a substance which is found generally on the surface of the skin. So this fungus, they eat on keratin in the skin, in the scalp of the hair and in the nails. So ringworm are generally found in skin, in the scalp of hair and nails. What kind of symptoms are seen in case of disease ringworm? These symptoms are, here some enlarged raised ring like structure is seen. That means on the skin some ring which is somewhat reddish or pinkish in color is seen, and itching is also there in the particular area. So infected skin shows enlarging raised ring of ringworms and they have intense itching. If this infection is there in the nails, infection is called as onchomycosis, where the nails may thicken, they become discolor, and sometimes after some time if the infection is severe, the nails become crumble and fall off. If the infection is in the foot region, the disease is called as athlete foot. That is also fungal infection which is generally seen in between the toes. It begins in the toes region. So these are the symptoms seen on the skin, in the nails and in the foot region. How this disease is transmitted? It is under modes of transmission. It is spread by sharing of infected clothes and the comb. And because of that, it should not be shared. Then how to diagnose the ringworm? It is simply by physical examination. That means the particular area where the itching we feel, that is examined. What type of treatment is used? For the treatment of ringworm, drugs available are nystatin, fluconazole, itraconazole, etc. And how to prevent? As you know, the mode of transmission, prevention and control is easy. That is to avoid close contact, avoid sharing of clothes, washing clothes in the hot water with fungicidal soap is also one of the, we can say, prevention. So avoid close contact, avoid sharing of clothes, and we can use the fungicidal soap also to prevent this disease. So this is about the ringworm. Later on we have to study one more disease which is called as common cold. Common cold, as you know, simply when we feel some cold-like feelings, having somewhat fever and headache along with the runny nose and all, these are the symptoms of common cold. So what is the causative agent for common cold? This common cold, it is because of acute coryza, acute cold, and which is, this common cold is also called as nasopharyngitis. See the word naso for nose region, pharyngitis for the inflammation of pharynx. So inflammation in nasal region and inflammation in pharynx, as the word ends with itis, is for the inflammation. It is also called as acute viral rhinopharyngitis, also called as acute coryza or cold. It is caused by viral infection to the upper respiratory tract, or by rhinovirus, or by coronavirus. See, these all are the causative agents are virus only, like corona. In case of corona also virus is responsible. Here also virus is responsible for common cold. Symptom of corona and symptom of common cold are very much similar to each other. Okay, so viral infection is the major cause of common cold. What kind of symptoms are seen? Symptoms are cough, sore throat, runny nose and nasal congestion accompanied with conjunctivitis. What is this conjunctivitis? Here the meaning is given in bracket as pink eyes. Sometimes we feel that eyes becomes reddish in color and some sticky fluid is get secreted in the eye. So that is because of infection of this virus we can see. It also involves muscle ache, that is pain in muscles and fatigue. Other symptoms are headache, shivering and loss of appetite. It also involves muscle rashes, headache, shivering and loss of appetite. This point is repeated here. So these are the symptoms. As before also many times I told you that question of 2 marks can be framed by using the headings like causative agent and symptom. May be asked for 3 marks, that means causative agent for 1 mark and any 4 points for the symptoms can be asked for 2 marks. So any type of question can be framed 1 marks, 2 marks or 3 marks. How to prevent this common cold? The best way is staying away from the infectious people as we are following in case of corona case. Second is hand washing with plain soap and water. As well as alcohol based hand sanitizers also provide protection and use of mask and handkerchief to cover mouth and nose. Nothing is important here. Actually all these points are important but you can write by your own. No need to study and to learn the points. One more disease we have to study today, that is dengue. This dengue causative agent is, there are 4 types of viruses are there, in short called as DENV. So any one of this virus can cause the disease. Remember that it is a vector borne disease which is transmitted through the bite of female Aedes mosquito. About different kinds of mosquito we have studied before also. For example, one of the disease malaria, where the vector is there and that vector is a female Anopheles mosquito. So your vector borne disease, that means if a person is infected with dengue and if there is Aedes mosquito is present, especially female Aedes mosquito, if that female Aedes mosquito bite an infected person, then this virus will enter into the body of mosquito. So we can say that now the mosquito is infected one, and this infected mosquito, if it bites a healthy man, then it will be transmitted to that. Again, prevention and control will be the same, that is use the mosquito net, use the insecticidal material and all. So it is not given in more detail, simply you have to learn causative agent and its vector, that is female Aedes mosquito. Now one more disease which is called as pneumonia. This pneumonia is caused by variety of pathogens where some viruses, bacteria and fungi all are present. So pneumonia can be caused by virus like adenovirus, para influenza or respiratory syncytial virus called as RSV. Pneumonia can be caused by bacteria also. Bacteria responsible are Streptococcus pneumoniae, and it can also be caused by fungal infection, and the fungal pathogen are Pneumocystis xerovecti and Pneumocystis carinii. It can also be caused by chemical burn or by physical injury to the lungs. So remember, bacteria, virus, fungus, chemical burn or physical injury to the lungs is common, that means it can cause the pneumonia. Remember that as the causative agent are viruses, bacteria and fungus all, infection is the main reason causing pneumonia. What are the symptoms for pneumonia? Again, symptoms are as same as that of we can say common cold, but some specific changes are there. First one, cough producing greenish or yellow sputum. That means the cough which is get formed inside, its color becomes yellow or phlegm. It becomes greenish or yellow sputum or phlegm. High fever with shaking chills is there. That means case of pneumonia, the fever which is developed, it is very high and shaking chills are also there. That means we feel coldness also, which shows shivering. Because of shivering here, fever is get developed and that becomes very high. So high fever with shaking chills. Shortness of breath with sharp or stabbing chest pain. That means we cannot breathe properly. The breaths which are there, inspiration, expiration, they are very short, as well as having chest pain during deep breaths. If you try to get deep breath, it results in chest pain. Headache, loss of appetite, fatigue, nausea, vomiting, joint pain, also the muscle ache is there. Okay, so remember, symptoms can be asked for 2 marks, causative agent for 1 mark. Now, prevention and control we have to study. How to prevent this disease, pneumonia? As we know, it is because of infection of bacteria, viruses and fungus. Staying away from the infectious person is the most important thing. Secondly, vaccination. Vaccines are available. So, if a person is vaccinated before, this disease can be prevented. Vaccine against Haemophilus influenzae and Streptococcus pneumoniae in the first year of life, that means just after the birth, if it is given in the first year of life, it reduces the chances of pneumonia. How it is transmitted? As I said, it is because of virus, bacteria or because of fungus. It is spread by direct person-to-person contact. It is also spread by droplets released by infected person and also spread by shared clothes and utensils. So what is the droplets? Droplet infection is because of sneezing. So in case of coronavirus, we are using mask. Mask is for what? To prevent this droplet release. So if the droplets release are there because of sneezing, because of coughing and all, it can be prevented. So for pneumonia also, this is important, that is to prevent this droplet infection. Okay, so prevention and control and modes of transmission we have studied. See, here some diagrams are there. This is Aspergillus mold. Aspergillus belongs to fungus. This is a virus called as adenovirus. Streptococcus pneumoniae, a type of bacteria, and Legionella pneumophila, all these are the causative agents for this disease, pneumonia. This diagrams, for what purpose? Without label it is there, simply to identify the pathogen. That means diagrams will be given in the textbook, in the question paper, and can be asked, label this. That means just simply give the name of this diagram and responsible for which disease. So Aspergillus mold, adenovirus, Streptococcus pneumoniae, and Legionella pneumophila, all these are the causative agents for pneumonia. In this topic, in this lecture, we have studied 3 different kinds of diseases like pneumonia, common cold, dengue, and ringworm. That is 4 kinds of diseases we have studied. Remaining diseases we are going to study in next lecture.